Hey there, this is Chris with Whole Apple and Whole Apple TV. Thanks for joining us today. Today we have a special kind of unbox and review because we've got something actually from Apple Computer, which is a little bit new for us. It's not new for me. I actually worked with Apple back in the late 90s, did some consulting, and as a magazine editor back then, I was able to call them and get pretty much whatever I wanted. But it's a little bit different now with the web and everything else, and got to work your way back up to where you can request products. But they have sent us something in this little baby box. What could it be? It is the ITV product of the future, as far as Apple's concerned. This is the Apple TV 2.0. Second generation Apple TV, and it is probably going to be a pretty good holiday gift to give. At $99, it's kind of a no-brainer, something to play with and definitely look at. There is a remote that you can use for the iPhone and the iPod Touch, the iPad, of course. There's also a remote that it comes with. We'll unbox it here in a moment. One word of note, when you go to buy one of these, whether you buy it on Amazon or Mac Mall or directly from Apple or whatever, you're going to want to make sure to get one of these. And this is an HDMI cable that also does audio. So it's a 1.3 compatible HDMI cable. And you're going to definitely want to make sure to get one of those with your Apple TV, or you will have a $99 brick to play with on Christmas morning. So that would not be a good thing. I know Apple probably doesn't want me to say this, but it is jailbreakable already. And there's going to be a lot of stuff coming down from Apple, but also from the third-party kind of hacker scene to kind of turn this into an app store browser and a device that can run apps, different things. So both official and unofficial. But we're going to test it out officially and take a look at how it comes stock and how most people would typically tend to use it. And we think that this is going to be a pretty interesting buy for the holiday season simply because of its price and its capabilities. And if you're an Apple household, this is something that kind of, for $99, is something that you probably will wind up picking up or get as a gift for the holiday season. And, we're going to go ahead and open the Apple TV now and take a look at what comes in the unit. So this is a departure from the original Apple TV in that it does not have a hard drive. This is a streaming only device, so you're going to want to have a wireless connection, or probably preferably for HD content, you're going to want to have a hardlined Ethernet connection, which we have up in our home theater. So we'll go ahead and try it both ways, but we've got the Apple TV unit itself, nice and small, tiny. We'll take off our little covering, and we've got another plastic piece that goes all the way around the edge. And if we look at the back here, we've got our power, our HDMI, which is looks to be a mini HDMI, and let's take a look real quick. No, it's a it should be a standard HDMI. It looks a little bit smaller, but it's a standard HDMI, so you'd use an HDMI to HDMI cable. And we've got our optical audio, in case you want to run a separate optical audio, and then we've got our Ethernet port. So this also has wireless N built right in, but you can actually use wireless N or use your Ethernet port as well. It's got a flat, kind of a rounded base at the bottom, so it'll sit nice and flat, but it kind of makes it so look like it's hovering a little bit off of the table, if you can see right there. So that's the unit itself, and then the Apple TV comes with a standard Apple remote. This is the kind of one that you get or buy with your iMac or your MacBook Pro. So there's that, and then you've got, of course, the ability to use this with your iPhone, iPod Touch, or iPad and use the remote app that you can download for free from the App Store. So we'll be trying it out both ways. So you've got that, and we've got our power cable nice and wound up here. It's a flat power cable kind of looking thing. And then you've got the obligatory information for Apple TV and stickers. Yay, stickers. My new car, my new used new car, does not have stickers on it yet, and those look about just the right size, so that I know where those are going to go. And so we've got the FCC information, standard stuff, and we've got the Apple TV information that's pretty basic and shows you just how to hook the device up. So nice, small, compact form factor. You're going to need another HDMI port on your TV. A lot of times people run out of them, so you know, a switcher might be in order, but we have enough on our LG 60 inch to go ahead and hook that up. So we'll take a look at it right now and start hooking it up. And this may run into two parts, I think, for a video. Even though it's a small, inexpensive device, I think it might be worthy of two parts for a review. So look out for that second part, and we'll be right back and hook it up. And we're going to go ahead now and we're going to plug it in. I don't know if this auto turns on or not. We've got our remote that we're going to take a look at and try and move around a couple of different ways. But ultimately, we're going to use the remote of remotes, our iPad. And we've got it ready to rock with Apple's remote software. And it's going to be scanning for the Apple TV when it turns on. So I don't know if this is going to turn on and have a welcome or not, or what it's going to do. So let's just plug it in and find out. And then I'll go ahead and move the TV, the camera up, so you can see the TV a little bit better. So we've got a little blue light going. It's blinking. So it is on. We've got the screen repositioned, the camera repositioned, and we have our welcome to Apple TV. So we're going to use our remote here. And we're not going to choose French. We are going to choose English, because if we chose Japanese, we'd be in real trouble. So we'll choose English. Hear that sound. And we'll turn up the sound just a little bit more, so we can hear this fairly nice without blasting everybody out in the home. So we'll hit the button to choose English. Now, the iPad, it's finding the iTunes libraries and Apple TVs that have home sharing turned on. I've signed in via my home sharing account, or my Apple ID, into home sharing. And so this is not yet set up, but it's going to choose my wireless network. So we're on wireless right now. We're going to also be testing this with Ethernet. We'll hardwired in, and we'll let you know in the written review how that goes and the speeds and that kind of thing. But we're testing it right now with simply with Wi-Fi, which is wireless and 20 megabit connection. So we've got a pretty fast connection here. Help Apple improve its products and user support. We can go ahead and say okay for now. We should be able to turn that off at any given point. So that's a good thing. So waiting for network services. Zoom in a little bit here. See the full Monty. And it's going along. If we have any pauses like this, we'll pause it and let you know how long it takes. We're timing everything. So now see, I was being nice and I was waiting for Apple to do their thing and connect to the network and just work, but it actually is working just fine. So it's got computers, AirPlay, sleep now. So I don't think I have any iTunes set up right now. We'll turn on home sharing now. Okay, we're back with the whole Apple TV review. And we're taking a look, of course, right now at a Flickr stream, which is really cool. What I've done is I've set the Flickr stream. You can search through Flickr to select anything you want. So I chose the word Apple, and now it's just simply going through and selecting every image, which I have no idea why that one is, but it's selecting every image that comes up with Apple. And we've got the origami slideshow playing, so that's really cool. And now we're going to be hooking up our iPad, and we can go ahead and just connect to the Apple TV. And we're going to use the gestures. We simply go ahead and tap our little button here, and now our screen becomes a full-blown control, and we just hit the menu button And now we're back at the Flickr photo stream. So I'm going to use the iPad here to go over to the save search area, and I'm going to save that search because that was cool. And oh, wait a minute, you know what? I think I just deleted that. So one of the nice things about this is it has a keyboard, because typing on that is a friggin' pain in the ass when it comes to doing it with the Apple remote that's included with the Apple TV. The other thing too is that, you know, when you're dealing with the keyboard elements and you're using the Apple remote, if you go that way, you can't keep going that way and get to the other side. You have to go all the way over or all the way back, and you can't go that way or that way. So interface-wise, I don't think it's Apple's finest crowning achievement, but, you know, it is what it is. But with this, we've got the ability to use our keyboard. And let's see, we're going to go ahead and search. And the keyboard comes up. So then we just go ahead and type in our search, thank the gods, or thank God, the main one. And so there we've got our search, and we're going to go ahead and save that again. So we'll save our search. And then, you know, we can do a slideshow, but we'll hit back to the menu. We'll hit done, and we will go. Back again. And now we're back at the main interface, and we can go ahead and we can check all kinds of different things out. We've got our mobile me galleries, which are mostly my private family stuff. So we've got our movies, our TV shows, and we can search the top movies, for example. And they'll come up in a list view like this. We've got lottery. Let's see, lottery ticket 2010. Never heard of it. Starring Bow Wow, my favorite. Harry Potter, no. So, you know, this is a little bit more sensitive. And on the iPad, you know, there might almost be too much screen real estate when it comes to navigating this interface in certain ways. Starring Russell Crowe, spies, sci-fi favorites. So, you know, you got a good mix of stuff going on in here. So that's nice. We've also got over on internet, we've got our Netflix set up. So I've set all this up finally. You know, we had a rough road. We had a bumpy road getting going on this. But once we got going, it's really, really cool. It's very neat, and we really like it a lot. The Netflix interface is really nice on this. You know, you can go ahead and pretty much start any movie that you would like to start almost immediately. We've got movies for kids. These are new arrivals in TV. These are new movies that have arrived. They're not necessarily new. They're just new to Netflix. So, you know, you can start any movie you want and play it and rate it. And it operates really great. Now, we're on wireless end right now. We're only about 15 feet from the base point, from the access point. So we're not far away, and we're getting a really clean, strong signal on a 20 megabit connection. So your mileage may vary. But here we go. And you can see my iPad is just set here. I can go back to the menu at any time, which I will wonder if I can fast forward. Oh yeah, I can fast forward here. So, okay, so I'm simply holding, I dragged over and I'm holding to the right of the iPad like this. And I'm able to fast forward, and then I can let go and it will play again. I had to tap to play. So there you go. So if you tap again, you pause. So we'll hit the menu back to go out of there. And we can go ahead and hit menu again and again. We'll go back to, we'll check out YouTube for a minute. We will search for, oh, let's search for something like Whole Apple. Again, we've got the keyboard on our iPad. So we've got lots of abilities to do stuff like that. So we're not finding anything from our channel. Oh wait, let's do WholeApple TV, silly. Okay, so there we go. And remember, we've got a stealth armor contest going on right now. You can win some stealth armor gear. We'll be giving away a lot more prizes during the next 5 weeks. Hey everybody, Chris at WholeApple. Okay, so that looks really good on the big screen. That's really cool. All these videos were shot and recorded in HD, so they look really good on the Apple TV. So, you know, you can check us out on the Apple TV, and you can fast forward, you know, just like this. Get to wherever you want. So I'll hit play.
And it's really a fairly...
Actually, it works better on here than it does on a computer half the time. So that's really cool. So we've got the ability to do that. Go to our menu here. We can show more and related videos. Very cool. Very nice interface. Very well done. I like how it's blurred out. That's a cool feature. That's definitely neat. So we'll take a look at some more stuff as we go on. We've got some internet radio, some different things that we can check out. Getting back to the main menu sometimes can be a little bit odd, but you know, we've got our computers, we've got our library, Casting Crowns, one of my favorite bands, got our movies, iPhone developer stuff, got little doodles animations, got some podcasts going on. So these are all streaming from my Mac Pro to the Apple TV right now. And I got some iTunes U stuff, some drawing and some guitar stuff, some different things. Little Kids Rock for my daughter. And we don't have our photos set up yet, so we'll take a look at that at another time. But this looks pretty cool. And we've got different things. We've got AirPlay. Got different computers that we can hook up to. I'm not going to turn that off, so we'll exit out of there. And we can sleep the device. Just for informational purposes, we'll go to general and show you we've got basic network stuff, about, name, network, iTunes Store, any remotes we've got going on, software update, send data to Apple, legal, reset. So that's pretty basic. And you know, we go to about, there's the information. And our screensaver, we can set that to start after 5 minutes, show during music, photos, we can take that and we can go to Flickr and turn that to our Apple. And, you know, we can actually do a different search, we can add different ones, we can use our mobile me. So we're going to go ahead and go back to Flickr, choose Apple, and there we go. So hit our menu back, and there we go. So we've got movies, TV shows, internet. You're going to access your music through your library and, you know, find your playlist. We'll find all your playlists. We've got books that we can look at. We can do audiobooks. Some of my favorite sci-fi audiobooks here. Isaac Asimov Foundation series. I'm definitely a geek, guys and gals. So, you know, this is really cool. You know, we've got some classical music. You can see I don't really have that many playlists set up. I just kind of shuffle through 8,000 different songs for something different. But got some classical. And for some reason, I'm trying to get it to fast forward, but it won't. When I'm holding and dragging like that, it's actually switching the song. So okay, so I have to grab this little guy up here and slide him back and forth. So this is definitely, for $99, hey, I mean, this is pretty cool. You got your entire computer network, iTunes, all that stuff going, and you can totally do whatever you'd like to do. Now the music does keep going until you hit the pause button on the iPad here. So this is cool. You know, this for $99, what a great holiday gift to get somebody that wouldn't necessarily be expecting it. Make sure they have an HDMI port on their machine. But otherwise, this is a really, really great device. I think that you cannot go wrong with this. And this, by the way, is an awesome movie. If nobody's ever seen it, who's watching this, definitely check it out. Wanted, with Angelina Jolie. And the previews, if you've ever watched Voodoo, you know their previews suck. The previews here are good. 6 weeks ago, I was just like you, and then I met her. Kill one, save a thousand. That's what we believe in, and that's why we do it. We are a fraternity of assassins. So unless you're, unless you're on the other end of the house from your router, or you have a very, very slow connection, you should be able to get your broadband over Wi-Fi and not really have a problem with it. Some of the HD stuff I've heard has some issues speed-wise, but you know, you need a fast connection nowadays. Anything less than 6 megabit is not really considered a good connection. So if you have 6 megabit or greater, check it out. Make sure your kids are not downloading stuff off the BitTorrent networks while you're trying to watch a movie. But other than that, you know, you're good to go. And for $99, this Apple TV, I think, rocks. I think it's going to be a good success this holiday season, and it's definitely something you might want to check out. All the problems I had initially really can be resolved by going through and clicking through where it says waiting for that connection, resetting the device entirely, and then just going ahead and configuring it. But I highly recommend the moment that you get this hooked up, that you hook up your iPhone or your iPad or your Touch, and get that working as a remote, because if you have to enter in all that information with a keyboard, you're just going to want to shoot yourself. So, enter in all that information on the keyboard with your remote. So that is something to think about. But other than that, I think that the Apple TV is a really good device, and we'll be covering it a little bit more in the future as to how people are jailbreaking it and doing other kinds of really cool things with it, like running Nido TV and some other different things. But stock out of the box, once you get it working, I think you'll be pretty pleased with it. So this is Chris with Whole Apple and Whole Apple TV, and this is the Apple TV.